Have you ever spent hours watching tutorials only to realize you still can't build a single thing on your own? That's not you being bad at coding, that's something we call tutorial hell, and it's more common than you might think. And if you're in it right now, you're not alone. Most beginners get stuck there for months, sometimes even years. If we haven't met yet, I'm Pete, and I've been coding professionally since 2012. I've led developer teams in companies big and small. And I'll be honest with you, every single developer I know, including myself of course, has been through the exact phase. So, in this video, I'm going to show you exactly how I would escape tutorial hell in 14 days, step by step. Real projects, real progress. And I will also tell you the exact day where most beginners want to quit and why pushing through that day changes everything. Before we dive in, grab a piece of paper or open your notes app, because I'm going to give you a lot of actionable steps. And if you write them down, you will walk away with a roadmap you can actually follow for the next 2 weeks. Sound good? Let's start with why you're stuck in the first place. Why you're stuck. You're not stuck because you're lazy or because you're not smart enough. And definitely not because you don't have what it takes. The real reason, tutorials trick you. They give you this little dopamine hit that makes you feel like you're learning. The instructor types, you type. Their code works, your code works. You think, yeah, I've got this. But the truth is, you're just watching someone else do the heavy lifting while your brain sits in the passenger seat. It's like watching Gordon Ramsay cook potatoes. You can binge 1,000 episodes, but until you grab a pan and burn your first batch, you're not a cook, you're just hungry. And then comes the scary part. The moment you try to build something on your own, you open a new file, and suddenly your mind goes completely blank. That happened to me. I remember after finishing a React course, I felt unstoppable. The instructor typed, I typed. His app worked, mine worked. Then I opened a fresh project to build a simple login form. And it was like I had never seen JavaScript before in my life. I couldn't remember the syntax, wasn't sure of the structure, I didn't even know if the file should be .js or .jsx. I'm telling ya, total blackout. And my first thought, maybe I'm just not cut out for this. I shouldn't be a developer. That moment crushed me. And maybe you felt the same way, staring at a blank screen thinking, I will never figure this out. But here's the truth. That blank screen panic, that's not failure, that's the first real step to becoming a developer. Because coding isn't about copying along perfectly, it's about getting stuck, breaking things, Googling stuff, asking questions, and slowly piecing things together. So if that's where you're at right now, don't beat yourself up. You're not behind, you're not broken, you're just at the doorway. And over the next 14 days, I'm going to help you walk through it. Days 1 to 3, the warm-up. So how do you start breaking out of tutorial hell? The first 3 days are just warm-up. Nothing fancy, nothing complicated. Just getting your brain and fingers moving together again. Think of it like stretching before workout. You don't walk into the gym and deadlift 200 kilos cold. You warm up first, same with coding. So here's what to do. If you're learning Python, write a script that adds 2 numbers, or reads a file and prints the first 3 lines. For web development, make a page with a button that changes text when you click it. For game development, put a sprite on the screen and make it move with the arrow keys. For AI and machine learning, load a dataset and print the first 5 rows. That's it. Don't overthink it, just get something running. When I first tried this, I thought, this is way too basic. It doesn't even count as a project. But finishing even the tiniest thing gave me momentum. And momentum is everything. So for days 1 to 3, your mission isn't to build something impressive, it's to prove to yourself, I can start, I can finish, and I can make code to do what I tell it to. Stack those small wins and the bigger projects will not feel so impossible anymore, believe me. Days 4 to 7, project number 1. Now it's time for your first real project. Here's the rule, make it embarrassingly simple. If it feels too basic to show anyone, you're probably on the right track. Because here's the trap, most beginners, me included, try to build something huge right away. An e-commerce store, a full social network, or in my case, a new framework that would change JavaScript forever. Yeah, spoiler, it did not. It's still sitting on an old hard drive somewhere in my drawers. The problem with big projects, you drown before you ever finish. What you need is something small enough to complete in 3 or 4 days. So, for Python, a command line to-do list. For web development, a notes app with create, edit, and delete. For game development, a Pong or Flappy Bird clone. For AI and machine learning, a sentiment classifier that can tell if text is positive or negative. That's it. 3 or 4 features max. No login, no dark mode, no 15 extra ideas you saw on Reddit. Just finish a freaking project. And I'll be real with you. The first time I tried this, I wasted 2 whole nights arguing with myself over button colors, blue or green. Why? Because I was terrified to actually finish. Procrastination level 1000. Maybe you will catch yourself doing the same, obsessing over fonts, variable names, or background images. But here's the truth, none of that matters right now. Your only mission for days 4 to 7 is this: finish a freaking project. Even if it's ugly, even if the code is messy, even if it feels small. Because finishing builds confidence. And confidence is the muscle you need to escape tutorial hell. Day 7, the wall. And now, day 7. The wall. This is the point where almost everyone wants to quit. You're building your little project, proud of yourself, and then suddenly it breaks. Nothing works, and you're sitting there thinking, what the hell am I even doing? That moment nearly ended my career before it even started. I once spent an entire Saturday stuck on a React button that was supposed to update some text. One button, one update. Hours of frustration. I copied random Stack Overflow snippets, prayed they would work. But nothing made sense. At one point, I literally said out loud, maybe I'm just not meant to be a developer. And honestly, that trap still gets me sometimes. Because now, with AI everywhere, it's even easier to fool yourself. You paste your bug into ChatGPT, copy the solution back into your code, and boom, it runs. It feels amazing until 2 days later, when you realize you have no idea why it works. And you're stuck again. That happened to me recently. I pasted an AI snippet, problem gone. But when I revisited the project, I couldn't explain what the code was doing. My code. I hadn't solved anything. I just delayed the pain. Maybe you've done that too. But here's the truth. This moment, the blank screen, the endless errors, isn't failure. It's coding. Because being a developer isn't about writing perfect code the first time. It's about breaking problems down, debugging, and understanding piece by piece. So when you hit the wall, here's my zero shame debug flow. Number one, reproduce the bug twice. Number two, isolate the smallest chunk of code that's breaking. Number three, read the error message out loud. Number four, print values, add logs, see what's actually happening. Number five, Google the exact error message. Number six, skim the docs. Number seven, still stuck after 20 minutes? Ask. Post on a forum, ping a friend, send a message on our Discord server, or yes, ask AI. But don't just paste the solution. Read it, understand it, rewrite it in your own words. That's what real developers do. So if you're stuck on day 7, remember this. You're doing the exact same thing senior developers do every single day. The only difference is they've just failed more times than you. Push through the wall, because once you do, you will finally understand what coding really is. Days 8 to 13. Project number 2. Congratulations, my dear legend. You made it past the wall. Now it's time for your second project. This one is different. Project number 1 was personal. Project number 2 is public. Something you can actually show another human being. Don't panic, you're not building the next Facebook. Keep it simple, keep it small. For Python, create a script that pulls weather data from an API. For web development, create a personal landing page with a contact form. For game development, a small level with a score counter. For AI and machine learning, a basic cut versus doc classifier. That's it. Ship something another person can run in under 5 minutes. And here's the temptation. Ask AI to build the whole thing for you. Copy paste, done. But that's just tutorial hell with a shinier teacher. Here's how to use AI the right way. Ask it to explain an error message in plain English. Use it for boilerplate so you don't waste time on setup. But don't let it do the thinking for you. Struggle a little, break it, fix it, then you will own it. I learned this the hard way. Once I let AI write half my project, it ran beautifully until a bug showed up. Suddenly, I had no idea where to start because the code wasn't mine. I was locked out of my own project. So don't rob yourself of the learning. Build it yourself, use AI as support, and then share it. Post it on GitHub, write a README, even better, drop it in our Discord community. Trust me, the feedback and encouragement will be priceless. Because once your work is public, you're no longer just learning in private. You've crossed the line into being a real developer. Day 14, publish and share. Day 14, the finish line. This is where most people freeze, not because the project is broken, but because now you have to show it to someone else. And hitting publish for the first time feels terrifying. It's like singing karaoke, stone cold sober. Your brain screams, what if they laugh? What if it's not good enough? What if they realize I'm a fraud? I felt the exact same way. The first time I pushed the project to GitHub, I hovered over enter with my heart racing. I was convinced that the world would see my messy code and laugh me off the internet. But you know what happened? Nothing. Nobody laughed. And the few people who did notice, they respected it, because finished and shared beats perfect but hidden every single time. So here's your mission for day 14. Publish. Push your project to GitHub. Write a short README with what it does and one thing you learned. Post it online, Twitter, LinkedIn, Discord, whatever. Even if it's messy. Especially if it's messy. And here's the thing. If you leaned too heavily on AI before, this step will call you out. Because the second someone asks you about code, you will know instantly if you understand it. That's a gift. It forces you to own your work. So don't hide. Don't wait until it's perfect. Ship it. Share it, own it. Because on day 14, you stop being someone learning to code in private, you become a developer who puts work into the world. And I would love to see your messy project, so hit me up on Discord. So, here's the real talk. After 14 days, you won't feel like a coding genius. You will still forget syntax, you will still Google the same error 3 times, you will still wonder if you're good enough. And that's okay, because that's what real developers do. I've been coding since 2012, and just last week I googled how to get the last item in an array, in JavaScript, again, after 13 years. That's not failure, that's normal. Because coding isn't about memorizing everything, it's about shipping, failing, learning, and slowly leveling up. And yeah, AI is part of that now too. It's an amazing tool, but it's not a substitute for understanding. Use it to explain, to speed things up, to inspire you. But don't let it steal the struggle. That struggle is where the real growth happens. So, if you followed this 14-day plan, here's what you should be proud of. You warmed up and got everything running. You finished your first project. You pushed through the wall. You built a second project and shared it with the world. That's 2 weeks, 2 projects, and proof that you're not stuck anymore. Now, before you go, grab the free PDF roadmap I made. It's got the daily schedule, the project ideas, and the debug checklist all laid out. Print it, stick it on your desk, and use it as your compass. The link is below. And remember this, you're not behind, you're not broken, you're just one finished project away from momentum. If this helped, hit like, subscribe, and share it with that one friend that is still stuck in tutorial hell. Now, go out there and finish a freaking project. Thanks for watching, you legend. I'm Pete, and I'll see you on the next one.